presets, actions, and filters, whatever you want to call them. They can be costly, and we're going to discuss that in this video. But what I really want to focus on is my experience with presets and how you can avoid the same mistakes that I made. What is happening, people? My name is Gaurav and I'm a travel and a wedding photographer based in Birmingham, England. So we've all dealt with presets, whether it be a Photoshop action or an Instagram filter. Essentially, they all do the same thing. They apply a specific look to your image with a click of a button. With Lightroom and Photoshop and a lot of these other professional editing software, you can pay money to buy these presets, and they can come at a really high cost at times. So you would think that they would work on every single image, right? Just because they're really expensive. That's not the case, unfortunately. And I learned the hard way. This preset, for example, if I was to sell this preset to you and give you a before and after, and you went and applied this preset on one of your images and weren't quite happy with the results, it's not necessarily the fault of the person trying to sell you the preset, because what they are already doing is showing you that if your image looks like this and you apply this preset on it, it would look like that. So they were giving you the before and after. And if your image doesn't have a good starting point like theirs, then the final result will not look similar to theirs. So if you think by paying a lot of money for a preset will automatically enhance your images like theirs, it most likely won't. You still have to have a good starting point. You have to have captured that image in a similar sort of environment to begin with to achieve that final output. And I used to do this myself. So I used to buy these presets thinking my images will look like this if I buy this preset, when I finally figured out that I wasn't just capturing the images like theirs. 80% of my images were captured indoors as opposed to outdoors like theirs. So next time you're considering buying these presets, just ask yourself, are your images captured in a similar sort of environment as you're seeing on the website that you're going to buy the presets from? Don't get me wrong, I'm not saying you have to capture your images in the same location as you're seeing on the website that they're trying to sell you the presets. I mean, that would help, but that's not always the case. What I'm trying to say is, don't be disappointed if your images look totally different if they don't achieve the same result with a click of a button. Very rarely you would apply a preset the first time and you think, yep, that's perfect, that's what I'm gonna go with, because your images aren't going to be exactly the same as the examples that you're seeing on the preset websites. Presets are just a starting point. So what's the solution to all this then? Should you not buy presets at all? Should you just ignore them? And what's the alternative? Before you buy presets, you need to understand that they are not a quick fix for everything. And in my opinion, the reason why they charge a lot of money is not because they want to rip people off. They're charging you for their experience. They're charging you for the time it took them to get to that stage in order for them to develop these quality presets for you. So this video is not to badmouth a lot of these companies out there charging you for these presets. It's more to set your expectations on what you can achieve. So how can we improve our chances of getting better results from these presets? So number one is having a good starting point. If you don't have a good starting point, your final result is going to be a lot more difficult to achieve. And number two is actually familiarizing yourself with how presets actually work. Now, there are many YouTube channels with videos out there that will guide you step by step on how to achieve these specific looks in Adobe Lightroom. I'll leave a link to some of these channels in my description below, so be sure to check them out. I've got actually one of my videos where I guide you step by step in Adobe Lightroom Classic on how to achieve a popular effect that I use for my travel photos, so be sure to check that one out too. Once you familiarize yourself with how to create these presets, you'll have a better understanding of how to modify any new presets that you apply to your image. If you then go and pay for these more expensive presets, you are more likely to achieve the desired look that you want, because you'll have a better understanding of how presets actually work. So just a quick recap, buying expensive presets will not make your images look great right off the bat. You will still need to have a good starting point, and the way to have a good starting point is to practice. The other thing you can do is you can follow these other YouTube channels that I've mentioned in my description below, and that way you get to practice and even make your own presets at the back of that. And essentially that's what you want to do. You want to make a handful of presets that you're comfortable with. So I'm going to leave it here for this video tutorial, guys, and I hope you get a better understanding of presets in the professional photo editing world. I hope this also answers questions like, why don't my presets work as shown on the website? Anyway, if you found this video useful and you know somebody else that will benefit from this type of knowledge, do go ahead and share this video with them. And I would really appreciate if you like and subscribe this video if you yourself have gained any sort of benefit from this. And I'll catch you in the next one.